to see all the flashing lights. You're like, you realize, you're, okay, we're really here for the Super Bowl. And then when you win, you hold up the Lombardi Trophy, and it's a unique thing that you've always worked for.
In just his second NFL season, Russell Wilson led the Seattle Seahawks to their first championship in franchise history. The 2013 team became the youngest to win a Super Bowl. Their hunger, talent, and confidence turned heads in a season with commanding results.
For a team of guys who were definitely scrappy, definitely an underdog, definitely weren't expected to win, but we had something special about us.
There was this deep brotherhood. Is that what made this team unique?
Oh, for sure. You know, to be connected, to be in unison with one another, to play together, to also share moments and share experiences, the good and the bad. I think that's been a special thing, and we've been able to do that for the past 4 years, really. And so it's been a very unique situation here.
Guys that loved one another, that depended on one another to do their job and to take care of one another. And with that common bond, I believe we were close to unstoppable.
And with a top-ranked defense that was nearly immovable. In Super Bowl 48, the team stifled a Peyton Manning-led Broncos offense by forcing 4 turnovers and returning 2 of them for scores. The Seahawks put up the game's first 36 points, leading to a 43-8 rout.
Just the fashion in which we did it, I was such in a dominating fashion against a really good team.
It was a blowout, a point in the game. You saw something that indicated to you, this could be a runaway.
You know, honestly, never really, you know, because you're playing Peyton Manning, you know, you never know, you know, but, you know, I remember being in the huddle with, you know, about 4 or 5 minutes left in the game, and I was still kind of trying to be a firecracker, making sure that everybody was still paying attention, making sure that we finished the game the right way. So, you know, I always believe the game's never over till it's over.
That reality was never more apparent than a year later, last February, while attempting to become the league's 8th back-to-back Super Bowl champions.
We won Super Bowl 48, and unfortunately we lost Super Bowl 49. That's as simple as that.
Simplicity that still refuses to dismiss the controversy of a second-guess call with 26 seconds left in the game. Trailing the Patriots by 4 points, with 3 downs, 1 timeout, and 1 yard to score, the Hawks' near-certain win was gut-wrenchingly intercepted.
Going back to last year's loss, walking off the field, What was the exchange, the dialogue?
Well, the whole experience, obviously, it was a tough one, but, God was kind of talking to me, just saying, you know, I'm using you, and wanted everybody else to see how he's going to use me and how I was going to respond. And so I think that's anything in life. I think that when you go through ups and downs in life, I think that God wants us to use us as vessels, you know, and so that people can, you know, see and really figure out who he really is.
They are Seahawks that see things differently. Players who look past prominence to purpose, able to inspire a lasting charge beyond their immediate successes.
It was a little empty, you know, just because you're at something you've always dreamed of and you find out that moment isn't as big as you thought it was. The final destination isn't the Super Bowl. It's part of it, and it's not what accomplishment really is. Accomplishment is each and every single day. And bringing glory to the Father.
Those back-to-back seasons, Where is the legacy for the Seahawks in this 50 years of Super Bowl history? Where does that fit?
It's too far to tell, you know? You just honor the Lord. I think that's what it's really about, play for an audience of one. And then I believe the rewarding experiences after that. I think that when you look back on the legacy of the Seahawks, hopefully it's not just multiple Super Bowls, but hopefully we were able to change lives and save lives.
Well, honestly, that ring and that title is gonna fade away. There'll be another one the next day, there'll be another one the next year. You can say you'll be remembered forever, but it won't last an eternity. And heaven will be for eternity.